Now I'll show you how to set up a female genital tract culture. This is another example of a primary or direct culture. We'll be using a swab, and we'll set it up on a blood auger plate, a Martin Lewis chocolate biplate, and we're going to make a smear on a slide. So we're going to set this female genital tract culture on a blood auger plate, a chocolate auger, Martin Lewis biplate, and we're going to make a smear on a slide. Make sure that we've labeled the media, and make sure you label your slide with a pencil so that it doesn't wash off during the staining process. And we're going to set this up from a genital swab. So take the swab out of the holder like this. So then inoculate your plates. You're going to hold the plates like this, and then you want to make kind of a nickel-sized area of inoculum on here like this, and I kind of roll the swab as I do that. So we want an area about this big. And you go on and do the same with the rest of the media. So I'm going to do the chocolate side here like this. And the Martin Lewis side right there. And then you're going to make your smear. You want to gently layer the material onto the slide by rolling your swab towards you as you move it away on the slide. And you should get, you don't want to do this because you can destroy your cells and your morphology. So you want to do that until you can see some material dried on the slide. And that looks pretty good. I can see some material on here pretty easily. So now we have inoculated the blood auger plate, the chocolate auger plate, the Martin Lewis medium, and made our smear. This is the general sequence for setting up any culture. It's always the blood auger first, then the least inhibitory to the most inhibitory. In this case, chocolate auger, then Martin Lewis auger, and then always make your smear last. You can place your smear on a heat block to make it dry faster if you like. Now we're ready to streak for isolation. So take a sterile loop, and you can see the inoculum right here. So then streak across your inoculum like this, all the way across both sides of the plate, and you can go back a little bit to really spread that out evenly over this area. Then you're going to flip it over to the sterile side of your loop, but actually in this case you don't want to reflame. With a primary direct culture like this, we don't have nearly the concentration of organism, so we don't need to pay as much attention of cutting down the amount of organism we have on our loop each time. We want to have a consistent amount coming out each time. This is very similar to the subculture technique, except that we don't flame between areas at all. And then one streak out from this last area like that. Okay, after streaking the blood auger plate, then we'll streak the chocolate auger plate, which is on this side right here. So you see the inoculum there. We're going to flame our loop. So flame between the media, but not between areas on the particular media. So then with a sterile loop, we're going to streak across that inoculum here. And then one swipe out here into this area of the plate. And then we're going to streak pretty much parallel to the divider like this, going out to the edge of the plate each time. So then you're going to take one swipe out from this area, then out into this corner, and then just streak it down like that. And when you finish that side, flame your loop, and we'll go on to the next side. Streak out the inoculum. And then one streak out from here. Streak like that. And then for the final area, streak out into this corner and streak it down. So now I'm finished with setting up the female genital tract culture. And the next step is to gram stain the smear.